podcast. This is Chase, who's been back from the veteran. We have Salsa. She's the chocolate lab over there. She is she's actually technically placed with her client. She's having some gastrointestinal things going.
She's having an upset tummy, essentially.
Yeah, but so we're getting that under control, and then she's going to move back to her client. We have Ripple, who's the handsome chocolate guy over here.
Having fun taking
looks like he's staring at a person, so that's good.
This is a really new experience for all of these guys. They're not used to seeing things like this, so it's really good for them. Some of them might be a little
concerned. I know, it's so creepy.
Don't be offended if they're nervous, it's not the first
time. And Ripple is going with a veteran in Georgia. We've got Whimsy on the end there, and she is not yet matched with the client, but she's at the point where we're looking at clients for her right now. So, Freedom Service Dogs is a non-profit. We rescue dogs from local shelters and shelters in other areas. So we work with some in Wyoming, Texas, Nebraska,
Missouri.
Basically anybody that may have appropriate dogs for what we're looking for, we're willing to work with as long as they can get the dog to us. We're pretty open for that.
We test the dogs, so we'll go to the shelter and we pick out dogs that we think are appropriate for the program. So they're dogs that are kind of around this size because they're going to be able to do a lot of tasks for people. The really small guys just can't hit like the light switches and, you know, pick up large items. And the really super big dogs, unfortunately, don't live as long. So we kind of try to pick guys with this size range. Anywhere from about 40 to 90 pounds is all we look for. When we find an appropriate dog in the shelter that we think is going to be a good dog to test, we'll go there and we run through sort of this.
Like 25 points on it, then try and assess the dog on to see how comfortable they are with everything.
Right, so it's things like we'll give them a food bowl and then we'll play with their face while they're eating and take a food bowl away and see what they do. We want dogs that are really people friendly and aren't going to have a problem with taking things from them. We want to see that they can, that they like to, you know, retrieve objects and stuff like that. So we'll throw a ball for them, throw a rope for them, see if they want to tug. You know, we want dogs that are motivated to do those kinds of behaviors. We want a dog that's really people-oriented, loves people, wants to work. Once we pull a dog from the shelter and take them into our program, if they make it in the program, they're with us for usually typically 7 to 9 months. They're paired up with a trainer who works with them primarily, but we all kind of work with each other's dogs. We get volunteers to come in to work with the dogs, which, by the way, if you live nearby and you're interested in volunteering, we have a lot of really cool random volunteer opportunities.
Love the help. Or if you just want to come and like hang out with dogs, that's fun too.
Yeah, you can come in, pet a dog, take a dog jogging, take a dog for a walk, take a dog for the weekends. We have a lot of people that will come in and just, you know, let the dogs have a break from the facility and